HCAM programming is supported by our viewers. Thank you. And by Golden Pond Assisted Living, honoring resident choice, dignity, and independence. Our health and wellness focus keeps residents active. Golden Pond, state-of-the-art senior housing and healthcare services.
And by WPC Pest Control, a family-owned business for over 35 years. Owners Jim and Rebecca Mazzucchelli provide honesty, respect, and integrity, performing safe and effective pest control services. They service your home like it's their home.
Hello, and welcome to this best of edition of HCAM News. Tom Nappy at the anchor desk, and on this edition of HCAM News, we'll reflect back on some of the happenings throughout 2016. Project Just Because hosted Christmas in July. The event took place at the Faith Community Church, and a large turnout was on hand to help raise funds for the local charitable organization that has done a ton of work to help members of our community.
My name is Colette Cronin, and I'm the operations manager at Project Just Because. It is a great organization. We fill general request needs as well as backpacks, holiday, and lots of other programs throughout the year.
I founded it 17 years ago in my basement. I'm Sherilyn Lambert Walsh, and we started by planting a little seed, and everyone's watering the garden of helping families in need. And years ago, we also took over the Hopkinton Food Pantry. So we do year-round programs, just basic needs to help people.
Project Just Because hosted their fifth annual Christmas in July fundraiser. This year, the event was hosted at the Faith Community Church, and a big turnout was on hand to help the charity give back to the community.
This is our fifth year doing it, and it is a fundraiser in July with a Christmas theme, because in Christmas time, holiday time, we do 15,000 children and help them. But in order to continue being able to get the needs met, we try very hard to do fundraising in the summer when a lot of people don't think as much about families in need because there's other things going on, and it's summer and fun, and we help the families every day.
There were many great auctions and raffles, as well as plenty of activities for all ages.
We have so much going on here tonight. We have live auction items, silent auction items. We have mystery packages wrapped up like Christmas presents. We have pictures with Santa. So all the money is to help us to help people in need.
The event featured a performance by the Troublemakers Chorus, which, despite the 90-degree weather outside, helped get the crowd in the Christmas spirit. The festive event continues to be one of the biggest events for Project Just Because and their efforts to help those in need throughout the community.
Months and months of planning. So we had a committee that helped out, and we all came together to get the items and decorate and make everything come together for a nice evening.
People are very kind. They just come, and everything's donated tonight, so any proceeds go directly to help families.
We rely on volunteers, so we have a lot of people coming in to help us out. And then at holiday time is a great time for companies to do drives for us, for warm blankets, gifts for kids, hats and mittens, things like that, so that we can help out thousands and thousands of kids at the holiday time.
Lieutenant Governor Karen Polito met with Hopkinton town officials to finalize a community compact agreement with the town.
The agreement was put in place by the Baker-Polito administration, and more than half of the communities in the Commonwealth have applied to become a compact community.
The document we're going to sign today is designed to help the town get resources to address two important elements. The first is a community-sponsored agriculture initiative. As everyone in town knows, we bought the Pratt Farm earlier this year, actually late last year, I take it back, and one of the uses we hope to have on it is agriculture to fulfill one of the goals of the community, which has always been to have a community-sponsored agriculture out in the town.
The agreement will also allow the town to apply for various state grants.
That the communities that are participating in the compact, which Hopkinton is now one of them, can now compete for an information and technology grants. So we will offer up to $400,000 in grants for an IT project in your community. So if you can think of a way to use technology to solve some of your local problems,
we have some ideas.
Got some ideas on that? You should apply. So the idea of this program is to incentivize, you know, good decision making, and by being a compact community, you will now get bonus points for the larger statewide grants that are available, from MassWorks, which is the infrastructure grant program, to parks, to complete streets. You have, you know, put yourself on the list a little higher place to be considered for some of those funds. So good for you, really strong leadership here, sense a lot of energy and commitment, and more importantly, forward thinking, you know, where Hopkinton needs and wants to be, and we're very happy to be here today to support your efforts to help you achieve this success. So, I said this in the last one. January 26th is an anniversary date here in our Commonwealth because it was 1 year ago that Snowmageddon began. We had over 26 inches, 30 inches in some places in our Commonwealth a year ago today, and I'm really happy that today is a nice, bright, clear day for all of us.
Lieutenant Governor, the trains are moving.
Good. They are.
Governor, thank
you,
so much.
Very yeah. much. And the trains are moving today.
Thank you,
thank you so much. Thank you. I'm very happy to be here in the town of Hopkinton with our local leaders to form a community compact. That means we're really emphasizing the relationship between state government and our municipalities. And today, Hopkinton has come forward to sign the compact and to focus on both an agricultural initiative on Pratt Farm, as well as understanding the future economy here in Hopkinton and how they can really partner with private business to strengthen the jobs and the economy here. So two great best practices that Hopkinton has chosen and the state is as a partner funding and helping them achieve over the next 2 years.
Excited?
Woo!
Okay, good luck already. In 3, 2, 1, go!
The Hopkinton Lions Club chose two lucky raffle winners that won 4 minutes to run around Price Chopper and grab just about whatever groceries they can get their hands on.
It was exciting. It was fun for a great cause, too.
The proceeds from the raffle went to benefit Project Just Because, Mass Eye Research, among other numerous local causes.
Well, the main intent of the grocery dash was to try to raise funds for the Hopkinton Lions Club and support some of the numerous charities we support in town and within Massachusetts. So for example, Project Just Because is one of the entities that we love to support. Cheryl Ann Lambert Walsh, she's been wonderful. So some of the proceeds go to that, any money we raise to the Hopkinton Lions. Also, one of the main mission of the Lions Club is to prevent blindness, so we'll also be donating any proceeds to Mass Lions Eye Research. Then also any other money that we raise through this event or others, we just had a lobster raffle, or anything we donate to library, to the local respite center, fuel assistance. If someone in town needs some eyeglasses, we'll try to support them that way too. So the main mission was to basically raise funds, but also have fun doing it too. it was kind of a fun project for the club, going out and trying to sell tickets and advertising it. And the other thing is, you know, kind of bring the community together to let know that the Lions Club is around. We're always looking for new members, and so as to raise money, but also have fun doing it. So that was basically the mission.
Eric from Ashland was one of the lucky winners that got to collect some free groceries.
I think almost 700. I think this gentleman is going to be well above that. Good for him. He had a good strategy.
Jim Ryan was also one of the winners, and he collected groceries for a teacher at the Hopkinton Learning Center, Melody Ring, who was battling pancreatic cancer.
It was great. I grew up watching the show, so when my aunt won and offered me the chance to run for her, I was ecstatic.
Were you satisfied with the amount of groceries you got?
Definitely. I missed one aisle that was on the plan, but besides that, very happy. All of it's, or 99% of it's being donated to someone at the Learning Center of Hopkinton, part of the family there who's ill, and so it's going to be going towards her and to help take care of her. That's why I spent so much time in the frozen food aisle trying to get meals for her.
A few weeks ago, the Learning Center hosted a bake sale to raise funds to help the longtime Hopkinton Learning Center teacher. The grocery dash was a lot of fun for all and benefited several great causes.
I really appreciate all the people that, you know, took a chance and and bought a ticket. So it went well. We were able to sell some tickets at Poly Arts, the summer band concerts on Sundays. Other people. So yeah, it was fun. So we raised some money and had fun doing it.
Bill mentioned that the Hopkinton Lions Club works very closely with Price Chopper Management to plan this event.
Surgery. That's why he's not too talkative today or stuff. But anyway, he's a pleasure to work with, and this is a wonderful event. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, and then the profits will go to some great charitable causes. One of our beneficiaries in town is the Project Just Because, the food bank, and the wonderful things they do. Also with the Lions, one of our priorities is preventing blindness, so we'll donate some to Mass Lions Eye Research. And then a lot of other charities in town, the Respite House, the Post Prom, the library, whatever we can donate to. We'd love to support the community and also the Lions, things like Mass Lions Eye Research. But thanks everybody for coming. Thank you very much.
Thank you. HKM News is supported by our viewers and by Hopkinton Drug, located in this historic New England town since 1954. They are a multifaceted store dedicated to providing clients with an array of healthcare options.
And by Webster First Federal Credit Union, providing financial products with attentive customer service to the local families and businesses of Hopkinton. Visit us at WebsterFirst.com.
Hopkinton Hillers and Ashland Clockers rivalry match in Hilltown. Bottom of the third, two runners on, no outs. Jeff Haller with a little harmless bunt.
Bunt is in fair territory. Slow roller, throw to first, and he'll get by the first baseman, and the runner from third will come around and score. It's 1-0 Hillers.
Oops, not so harmless. Two on now, and Jack Vicari takes advantage of the situation.
On the ground left side, nicely fielded on the hop, but the throw in is going to be late, and the run will score.
One out now, Alex Reynolds keeps things rolling.
Left-handed pitch, and this is hit in the air towards left field, and that is going to drop down for a base hit. One runner being waved around, and the other runner right behind him. Here's the third run, here is the fourth run. It is a two-run base hit for the Hillers.
4-0 Hillers, but not for long. Ashland strikes back on the top of the fourth. Two on, no outs for Mitch Porter.
Delivers. And this is hit in the air to deep center field towards the fence. That'll drop in for a base hit. That is going to be a ground rule double.
The ground rule double scores one, and then this happens.
That is up the middle, past the reach of Aussie. Picked up by the shortstop, throw to first. And they do get the out at first, but a run does score. Onsi delivers. This is up the middle. Onsi will glove it. Throw to first. And they get the out. Now the throw home. Not in time. And Ashland comes up with their third run of the ballgame. Mitch Porter flies down the line.
No runs would score again until the top of the sixth. Michael Krupe at the plate with two on does this.
And this is hit into left field, past the reach of LeBlanc, and the game-tying run will score. Now the lead run being waved around, he will score as well. It's 5-4, Ashland.
5-4, Ashland. Hillers down to their final six outs. Two on, one out for Drew Simme in the bottom of the sixth.
Hit in the air, it is in fair territory, over to right field, it's caught. Runners going to tag from third. The throw home is going to be over his head, and it's a tie ball game.
And then after that, this happens.
And as this is tattooed into left field, that'll drop down. Runner being waved around, and the Hopkinton Hillers retake the lead, 6-5. An RBI single for Alex Reynolds.
The Hillers get the miraculous 6-5 win and hand Ashland their first loss of the season. Alex Reynolds was the star of the game, going 3-for-4 at the plate with a double and three RBIs. The next day, the Hillers kept the winning trend going as they defeated Bellingham 7-4. Hopkinton now stands at 3-2 overall on the season.
Will the Hillers take home the state championship for the second time in three seasons? Yes, they will! Hopkinton wins as Peyton Weber gets the winning point on the serve, 25-23 in set number three. And your Hopkinton Hillers are the Division II state champions. Unbelievable.
What an ending. What a way to finish that off.
Congratulations to the Hopkinton Hillers. They have claimed their second state championship in the past three seasons and have dethroned the 2015 state champion, Notre Dame Academy Cougars. How you doing?
I'm good. I'm great.
You won the state championship. How does it feel?
It feels amazing. It was so much fun to play in this whole tournament, so it's awesome. It feels so great.
Can you talk about the team this year and just this incredible run? What was it like playing with your teammates?
Oh my, I love my teammates. We had such a good season. We had so much fun together. And I think like the chemistry we had on and off the court just made it such a great team, and we had so much fun. It was awesome.
Well, can you talk about your performance today? You played against a team that also won a couple state championships in the past four seasons. There it is. Hold that up. Hold that up. State champions right here. How are you feeling right now?
I'm really excited right now. A lot of emotions.
Well, you played against a great Notre Dame Academy team out there. What did you expect coming into this matchup? Did you think that you were going to get the sweep? Did you think it was going to go five sets? What were your thoughts coming into this tonight?
I expected that it would be a really good game, and we hoped that it would be a sweep, but we didn't know for sure, and we were so excited. We played them 2 years ago and won, so we just really wanted to win again, so it was awesome, yeah.
All right, what comes next? Celebration time?
Yes, lots of celebration, yep.
All right, well, you certainly deserve it. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
How you doing?
Really good right now. I'm so excited.
What was it like playing with this team all season in this run? What's it been like for you?
Incredible. I'm so proud of these girls. We work so hard every day, and I'm so proud of how far we came.
How much prep work went into preparing for this great Notre Dame Academy team?
Oh, so much effort, so many hours in the gym, Saturday practices, just working so hard.
Were you nervous at all coming into this afternoon, or did you have confidence that your team was going to go out there and bring home another title?
I was so confident in this team. We were just so awesome, so happy.
What comes next? Celebration time?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Big bus ride home.
I'm sure it's going to be a fun bus ride.
Oh, yeah, lots of screaming.
Well, you certainly earned it. Congratulations.
Thank you. I'm feeling pretty good. Stay champs.
Absolutely.
Stay champs.
What's it like to be able to say that you're state champions? Has it really hit you yet?
No, it hasn't. It we couldn't believe that we actually made it this far, and now I can't believe that we actually won. So we're psyched right now.
What's it been like playing with this group all season long?
Oh, it's been amazing.
Yeah, it's been such so a special group.
Yeah, we're all such good friends, and we love playing together. So, yeah.
Any big plans for the celebration?
Hoping for a police escort on the way home, and then we'll probably hang out, get some food.
Absolutely. Well, you certainly deserved it. You must be hungry after playing so hard out there today.
Yes, definitely.
All right, well, go enjoy with your teammates, and congratulations. You're state champions.
Thank you.
How does it feel to be able to say you're a state champion?
It feels great. I mean, we've worked so hard for this. I don't think we could be any happier right now. We are so excited.
You had a tremendous game out there, as did a few of your other teammates as well. What was it like coming into this against this Notre Dame Academy team that's won two state titles recently? Were you nervous at all, or did you feel like your team was ready to go?
I think we were pretty excited. I know we've been doing well the past couple years, and so have they. I heard they've been in the state finals for the past 3 years, so coming in, we knew it was going to be a good game where we could really have a nice matchup, so we were all really excited.
What's it been like playing with this group all season long?
It's the best group of girls. I love everyone on the team. There's no drama, no nothing. We're just all like one big family, so it's been awesome.
Well, I think it's going to be a good bus ride home for
Definitely.
You, to say the least.
Very excited for the bus ride.
You're a state champion. Congratulations.
Thank you.
How does it feel to be a state champion?
It feels great. I'm so excited.
What was it like playing with this group all season?
It was awesome. All I have to do is just get to the setter, and they do the rest. So.
Now, you played a team today that also recently won a couple state championships. Were you nervous at all going into this matchup, or did you feel like your team was ready?
I think we were prepared. We've been preparing all season, and this is just another game, I feel like.
What comes now? Celebration time?
Oh, yeah. We get the police escort.
Well, congratulations. You certainly earned it. You're a state champion.
Thank you.
Awesome. Second state championship in 3 seasons. How does it feel?
Who would have thought it, right? It feels great. The girls came into the season with a preseason goal of being state champs. I mean, none of these girls were on that team. 4 of them were pulled up during that team, but none of them were players on that team during the season. But they had the goal. It's a winning tradition in Hopkinton, and they had the talent. It was just such a small, it's a small, close-knit group. So,
what's this group been like to coach?
Such a joy. Such a joy. I mean, this is a smaller roster than I've carried in probably ever, and they were just so close-knit, tight, that it just translated well onto the court. They helped each other out, picked each other up, always kept positive, and it was a pleasure going to practice every single day and showing up for games, and I don't know what I'm going to do. Actually, tomorrow's banquet. I don't know what I'll do on Monday.
What were the practices like coming into this matchup, getting ready for this Notre Dame Academy team that has also won a couple state championships recently?
So we really played it one game at a time. So we were getting ready for Amherst and through Wednesday, so we knew we had 2 days to get ready for NDA. Thank you. And basically, we believed in ourselves, and we know that we're a very well-balanced team, and if we played our game, we've got offensive weapons all over the court. We've got defensive just weapons back there picking up all the hits. They're a very strong team. We knew that coming in, but I think to be the best, you got to beat the best, and we were hoping to be able to see them at some point during the season. So it worked out the way they were hoping, actually. So.
I know. How are you feeling right now? You just full of joy, or what? You seem like you're about to explode with joy.
I'm so proud. I am so proud. Like, every girl on this team, I'm so happy for the seniors. Like, I'm happy for their accomplishments. I'm happy they were able to reach their goals and to dig deep and, you know, accomplish what they set out to at the beginning of the season. And they're just creating their own legacy. I'm proud. I'm so happy for them.
Well, Coach, another great performance by your team and another great coaching performance by you. Unbelievable job. Congratulations.
Can I give a shout-out?
Absolutely.
I think a big, big part of why we were so successful in the postseason was the fan support. Like, we had people in the stands that were just cheering, and it definitely, the girls were playing harder. They were, you know, they wanted to do it for each other, for the coaches, for the school, and for their friends. So that was a big part of it. And the same, like, the sub-varsity coaches and my assistant, Mary Bransfield, like, we wouldn't be where we are without the support that we have. And there's so much talent in Hopkinton, and it's just being modeled by these sub-varsity coaches. So it's easy for me when they come in and they're, you know, from day one, ready to go and saying we want to win a state championship. You know, that's the confidence and stuff comes from what they're getting at the lower levels. And the administration too, we got everything we needed to make this a successful season. We were just supported 100%. So, you know, it's nice, but there's a lot of people that, you know, take a part and own
this
championship.
How about the television coverage that you get? Isn't it wonderful?
Actually, I was going to say, you guys are great. And I had so many people telling me that, you know, if they couldn't make a game that or a match, that they were watching it on TV. And it wasn't just the opposing coaches that was telling me that. It was, you know, a lot of fans that they can't get out. They're able to watch it on TV, and that's important. And thank you so much. We're looking forward.
Well, we enjoy covering the team a lot, and it makes it all the bit sweeter when there's a state championship that you're taking home as well. It makes it even more fun to cover.
You know what? It'll be a fun, loud bus ride, that's for sure. So, thank you.
Well, hopefully there'll be many more state titles and many more fun, loud bus rides. But for now, enjoy this one. You certainly earned it. Congratulations.
Enjoy right now. That's what we're going to do. So, and just reflect upon this amazing season. So, thank you.
There is.
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Just about do it for this edition of HKM News. Don't forget to stay up to date with everything Hopkinton by checking out our website, hkm.tv, as well as our Twitter and Facebook page. If there is a photo, video, or story idea you would like to share with us, feel free to email me at news@hkm.tv. With your help, we'll cover even more of our community. For everyone here at HKM, I'm Tom Nappy. We leave you now with the current community listings and upcoming government meetings. From everyone here at HKM, happy holidays and happy New Year's to you and your family. HKM is supported by our viewers and by Blackstone Valley Wealth Management, providing highly personalized financial planning, wealth management, and customized solutions through transparent, unbiased advice. Visit us at blackstonevalleywealth.com.